नमस्ते बच्चों, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर शिल्पाश्री शाह, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर ऑफ ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन यूनिवर्सिटी। सो टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट इन्फ्लेमेटरी डिजीज ऑफ हार्ट। सो वी ऑल हैव नो दैट देयर आर थ्री लेयर्स ऑफ हार्ट। वन ऑफ देम इज एंडोकार्डियम, दैट इज दिस इनर मोस्ट लेयर, देन मायोकार्डियम एंड देन द आउटर मोस्ट लेयर इज पेरिकार्डियम। द हार्ट इज द मेजर वाइटल ऑर्गन दैट पंप्स ब्लड थ्रू द होल बॉडी एंड सर्कुलेट दी होल बॉडी टू मेंटेन दी नॉर्मल एंड फिजिकल एंड सर्कुलेशन। ओके, नाउ व्हाट इज एंडोकार्डाइटिस? वी ऑल नो दैट आइटिस इज इन्फ्लेमेशन एंड एंडो इज द इनर मोस्ट लेयर ऑफ एंडोकार्डाइटिस इज इनर मोस्ट इन्फ्लेमेशन ऑफ इनर मोस्ट लेयर ऑफ द हार्ट। सो इट इज कैरेक्टराइज बाई इन्फ्लेमेशन ऑफ द एंडोकार्डियम। It is usually involves valve of the heart. Okay, common infecting organism is streptococci, fungus, for example candida, okay, or gram negative organism, etc. Now predisposing conditions that can increase the risk of developing the infective endocarditis include structural cardiac abnormality, for example mitral valve prolapse, then congenital defect, then rheumatic heart disease, etc. And intravenous drug abuse also can cause that endocarditis. Then how we will diagnose or what are the symptoms of this endocarditis? It is clinical manifestation are highly variable and depend on involvement of other organs. Okay, due to embolization of valvular vegetation fragment, bacterial seeding of distant foci or other development of immunocomplex. So there will be flu-like illness. Like sneezing, coughing, fever, etc. will happen. So treatment is directed against eradicating the specific infecting microorganism. Surgical intervention include valve replacement or resection is indicated for refractory heart failure also. Okay, then antibiotic can be given. Okay. Then is myocarditis. Myocarditis, what is myocarditis? It is the inflammation of the myocardium. Okay, so it is usually result from infectious organism, most often viral infection like coxavirus. Okay, but can also caused by hypersensitivity reaction, predominantly due to drug, then toxic agents, for example alcohol, cocaine or chemotherapeutic agent also can cause that myocarditis. Then chest irritation or some systemic disease also can cause myocarditis. Myocardial injury occurs through a direct invasion or production of toxin and induction of non-specific or specific inflammatory responses. It can be acute or it also can be chronic process. Okay, it may involve limited area of myocardium or may be diffuse and is often accompanied by pericarditis. Now clinical manifestation will be as in endocarditis, like flu-like illness, fever, fatigue, dyspnea, palpitation, chest discomfort also can occur. Okay. Then patient management includes supportive care, pharmacologic agents like diuretics, ACE inhibitor we can give, then beta blocker, then aldosterone antagonist is indicated for specific pathology. Okay. Then immunosuppressive therapy for a certain subgroup of patients and limited physical activity with avoidance of strenuous activity. Then is pericarditis. What is pericarditis? The inflammation of pericardium. So it can be precipitated by wide variety of causes, but majority of cases are idiopathic and can include other infectious agents that are involved in pericarditis. Okay. Malignant trauma, autoimmune disorder, pericarditis associated with cardiac surgery, arthritis, systemic lupus erythematosus, other inflammatory disorder like renal sarcoidosis, etc. Then renal failure, drug toxicity and chest irritation can cause pericarditis. Symptoms will like chest pain, dyspnea, a pericardial friction rub and ECG abnormality can be seen. Then pericardial effusion also can be seen, like fluid will be arise in the pericardial sac. It may be present and is often asymptomatic. Okay. The treatment of pericarditis again is like for pain we can give NSAIDs for symptom management, ठीक है, फॉर दोज हु रिक्वायर फर्दर ट्रीटमेंट नार्कोटिक एनाल्जेसिक कैन गिव कॉर्टिकोस्टेरॉइड और बोथ कैन बी यूज। ओके, देन व्हाट आर फिजियोथेरेप्यूटिक मैनेजमेंट, दैट इज आफ्टर सर्जरी और आफ्टर द सिम्टम रिलीफ विथ मेडिकेशन और ड्यू एज इन केस ऑफ एनी इन्फ्लेमेटरी डिजीज वी हैव सीन दैट द हार्ट मसल डज नॉट वर्क प्रॉपरली एंड फॉर दैट द सर्कुलेशन ऑल्सो गोज इन वेन और यू कैन से दैट द सर्कुल ड्यू टू सर्कुलेशन साइनोसिस कैन हैपन ड्यू टू दैट ऑल्सो फैटिक कैन डेवलप। सो ड्यू टू इम्प्रूव फंक्शनल कैपेसिटी एंड टू इम्प्रूव द वर्क ऑफ हार्ट वी हैव टू डिजाइन सम प्रोटोकॉल। ओके, कार्डियक रिहैबिलिटेशन इज द मेन पार्ट ऑफ दैट। So there are three phases of cardiac rehabilitation. First one is in inpatient department. Okay, here we will discuss about the condition of disease, severity of condition, or what are these associated symptoms that have developed with the patient. So we will note all this down. Okay, then after noting it down, we will work on the symptomatic problem. Okay, and we will treat it at symptom basis. Okay, like if for pain management, what we can do, we know that due to angina pectoralis or chest pain, the patient will not be able to do any exercise or any or can breathe normally. So what is our main role, we will first work on that to manage the breathing. Okay, so we will ask the patient to improve breath. How? By diaphragmatic breathing, by pursed breathing. What is their function? Diaphragmatic breathing, we will ask the patient to take the feedback. How? In semicircular position, we will ask the patient to do diaphragmatic exercise and place his hand in the abdomen, lower abdomen, and ask the patient to inhale and feel the movement of the abdomen. So they will notice again and again about the movement of abdomen, and by this the diaphragm will get in act. So thereby the relaxation also will happen and the body will get enough oxygen to balance the abnormality. Okay, next is pursed breathing. As we all know, it is a disease of heart. So in inflammation of the heart disease, there will be abnormal vital sign is the so common. Okay, heart rate will increase or the blood pressure can be increased. So what can we do? By pursed breathing, we will normalize the vitals. We know how to do the pursed breathing. Like, we will ask the patient to sit in a relaxed position, and then we will ask to inhale deeply through the nose and exhale through pursed lips with a long duration. Okay, the exhalation will be more will take more time than inhalation. Okay, these are some breathing exercises, and then we will ask the patient to improve functional capacity. We will work on their activities of daily living. Like, we will ask the patient to work, bad mobilization exercise. We will take them for a walk. Then stair climbing also can be given. Then we will see the auscultate. If there is any secretion in the lung, then we will have to clear the secretion by different chest physiotherapy, like in percussion, vibration, shaking can be given. Then after that, if the chest is clear, then surgical repairment can be done. Then after that, surgical repair, post physiotherapeutic treatment will start. Like, we will to prevent the complication of surgery, we will have to work on that again. Okay, so we will ask educate the patient about their condition. Okay, and how to improve this and get over this and go to their daily life or activities of daily living. And for that, we will have to work for secretion clearing, then functional capacity. For that, we can take one outcome like 6-minute walk test, 2-minute walk test, or like that we can take. Okay, then we will see that what is the distance they have covered during 6-minute walk test of on the second day or first or second day of surgery. Okay, then we will treat them, and after the treatment we will see that what improvement has been occurred. Okay, then at last when the patient will be able to do everything, then for better lifestyle or to prevent the surgical complication, okay, for the surgical complication we will ask them or we will educate them about the home exercise protocol. Okay, we will design some home exercise protocol and then ask the patient to do it regular basis. Okay, and if any difficulties occur, we will ask the patient to come again, revisit again and give their status of disease. Okay, that's it. That is all about the inflammatory condition of heart. So what we will learn today, we have learned that there are three layers of heart: pericardium, endocardium, myocardium. Okay, endocardium is the innermost layer, then myocardium, then pericardium. Pericardium is outermost layer. Okay, and any inflammation in the heart cause the different disease. Like in endocardium, endocarditis; in myocardium, we can say it myocarditis, and for pericardium, we can say it pericarditis. So, if there is any question like what the definition of, write down about inflammatory disease of heart. So, you have to write about all the three diseases. Okay. And if the treatment part is there, so we can, if the you have to write down about first about the prevention, then about the medical treatment, then PT management. Okay. So, this is all about today's class. Thank you. Krishna.